Are you worried? Are you stressed? Do you feel alone? Do you sometimes feel like there's no one there to help you? Well, I'm going to tell you something, and there are going to be things that you're going to have to change about yourself in order to be happy. First, I would like to explain that happiness is in the eyes of the beholder. I know you guys heard that before. Beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. Happiness is in the eyes of the beholder. The truth is in the eyes of the beholder. People over time change. You can't change a person overnight. You can, but you shouldn't. At least you shouldn't try to. Growing up, I was never a happy child. Even when I was laughing and smiling and having fun, something always came back, would tell me, "Why are you happy? Why are you having fun? There's no point in having fun right now. There's no point in being happy when all these things are going on that I can't remember, or at least was blocked or conformed to not think about it. When it comes to living life happy, I found it very, very difficult. I would seek drugs, marijuana mainly, cigarettes, and alcohol. I found it very hard to get along with people. I found it very hard to get along with myself, get along with my family. Though there was no reason for me not to get along with them. Well, actually, there was a lot of reason not to get along with them, I stand correctly, so don't quote me on that. And people would tell me because of the things I've witnessed, because of the things I've seen, that I should just forget about it, move on. And that's something I should probably try to do. But the only reason why I think people tell me this is because they got a secret. And they always got a secret. And a secret is something you just hope to hide. Even me, I have secrets. I have things in my head that I've witnessed, that I've done, that goes against every fiber in my body. goes against my nature as a whole. And it goes against the very being of free will. These things necessarily I don't always have control over, though I have control over my personality disorder. I don't have control of what other people say. So when it comes to being happy, instead of being focused on what other people are telling you, focus on what you want to tell yourself. And don't lie to yourself. Should never, ever lie to yourself. If you're being abused, you're being assaulted, or even lied to, hurt in any way, emotionally, physically, or mentally, you got to shut them out. Personally, I've went through years of just doing what people told me to do because I literally had no mental choice. Because they took that from me. My parents took that from me. Because I kept losing control. Because that's what they wanted. They wanted me to go insane. My parents, they're evil. Though they may sometimes have good intentions, reason to lie of their intentions are usually what worries me. And I believe a lot of people like me feel the same way. Whenever I would get into a conflict, I would put my head down. I would plug in my headphones. I would get mad. I'd get irritated. And then they'd pester me, and I'd get scared. When I say pester, I mean gaslight. For those people who don't know what gaslighting is, it's when you purposely don't do something that you know is going to piss that person off or cause them harm in a way that is just verbal. Because they know what they are about to say is going to hurt you. That's what I've went through. For years, people would tell me what I was, who I was, and what I am, and what they believe is going on. And they would never let me say what I believed, because my opinion never mattered. And because I was too scared of these people, I let them break my happiness. I let them take control. And when I say I let them take control, I mean literally, I had no choice. Like I said in my previous video, my parents, they would drug me. And not necessarily marijuana. I mean acid. I mean hallucinogenic. Cocaine. Meth. Crystal meth. Crack. And they would force these drugs in my food. They would force these drugs down my system. And I became afraid of them. So afraid that I had to escape to a mental state of mind where the only thing that really mattered was hurting these people. There was so much anger being built inside of me, inside my head. And so much fear that my heart would race. And I don't mean that, I mean like that. Maybe even faster. Just by a couple beats. And when these people would purposely get in my face and threaten me, they would make sure that I was scared, that I was defenseless. Mentally and physically. They learned that by breaking me down as a child, that they were able to create who I am today. Those who have lost their happiness because they were afraid. They were so afraid, like me, that they couldn't stand up for themselves. I'm here today. Because I lived in fear my entire life of my past. Though I'm not sure I was ever afraid of my past, not until today. Not until I started realizing what actually happened. Especially when these personalities would come out. When you're going through something like this, where someone is purposely trying to instigate you to drama and conflict. They're throwing conflict out of their mouth into your face. They're spitting these conflicts, these bad mojo. And as these people were spitting this bad mojo at me while I was going through my therapy, their goal was to make sure that I was crazy enough to do the things that they have done. And when you live in fear drives you. When they put this stuff in your head, it's like a part of you that stopped caring a long time ago comes out. It's like an infestation of a behavior a thought that you just can't control and you snap, like me. We black out. As things persisted to these this situation, I found myself lost, helpless, hopeless, and afraid. People out there, though, you are afraid, shouldn't be. Should be afraid of them and what they may say and what they may do. Never be afraid of what you are capable of. Because that's what I was. My parents would put these things in my head, degrade me, downgrade me, make me feel worthless. To the point where I hated them. I hated their guts, I hated society, I hated everything and everyone and every thought that came through my head. The things that I wanted to do to these people who hurt me. Nonetheless, they would deserve it. But these things drove me insane. This need, this consistent need to get justice, to get revenge. It's pointless. Just makes it worse. Makes it a lot worse. And in the end, the only person you end up hurting is yourself. When you're going through hypnotherapy like I have, you don't get to decide things for yourself because other people are making those decisions for you. Especially at a young age. My tip for those out there who are afraid and lost their happiness, lost their hope, and don't know what to do, is to not give up, to not stop thinking about it, but to use your pain and use your suffering and use the things that they have developed in your head against them. Because that's the only thing that makes sense when you're going through therapy like this. Can't help but to blame everyone else for your problems, because the problems that develop while going through the therapy are a force of nurture against nature, a force against faith. I should say, not faith. Force against fate. And when you go against fate, you go against faith. And that's what these people did to me. The hypnotism therapy, the constantly trying to drive me insane, was because my parents lost faith that I was going to be able to cover for them, because they knew how much I hated them. They know that I want them dead. They know that I am in so much pain, so much suffering, that the moment I remember everything, I still haven't remembered everything, but everything's there. Everything is there. If I had a chance to remember every single detail that I could possibly remember, I would take it. I would ask them to allow me to allow myself to go through my own brain. And it's possible, believe me, it's possible. Anything's possible these days. And with that knowledge, I would try to make things right. Between me and my brothers, and me and certain people I look up to, people I can't necessarily talk about, and if they are watching this video, if they are, I would hope that they would understand that I still was trying to make choices even after they were doing my therapy. I would go in and out, and they knew when I was in and out. They knew when I was coming back. Wasn't hard to tell. It's called human intuition, instinct. And I know I can't hide anything from anyone, really. And that made me depressed. I was not allowed to live the life I wanted to live. I was forced to live a life that would have made me kill myself. And that's exactly what I tried to do, is kill myself, because I lost my happiness. I lost my freedom. I lost my free will. And you people who are going through depression, unhappiness, you gotta start looking at your problems and stop asking questions. Like Mr. Beast said, or not Mr. Beast, but Beast, you know who I'm talking about. The guy I've been posting up down below of my website here. He's very inspirating, I gotta say. And people should probably listen to him more. Because I surely should. But if you let these people, these problems, eat you alive from the inside out, it's gonna start up here. But you're gonna feel it right here in your chest and your heart. I know you can't see it, but right here, you're going to feel it. Because it's going to be telling you, your heart's going to be telling you, your head, whatever. It's going to be telling you that you're not hopeless. And that there is hope for you. You just gotta remember what your problems are and just speak the truth. Once you own up to the problem, once you own up to the truth, what owns you? The problem or you? And this is what I believe people mistaken themselves. See, even though we have a government, and once they hear about the things that people have done, they're going to want to press charges. They're going to want to put you in prison if you've done something wrong. And I hate to say, I can't help you. If you are going to prison, if you are going to jail, I can't help you. Only you can help yourself by telling the truth. And if you lie, they're going to know. And the moment you lie, they're going to look at you, stir, bitch, crazy, stupid. And they're going to tell you, I'm done listening to you. I am done listening to what you're saying. And I don't have to listen to you because all you're going to do is spread lies. And if you cannot own up, if you cannot face your fears, if you cannot, then why do we call this America the land of the free, the land of the brave? You're not brave if you lie. You're ridiculous. You're pathetic. If you lie. And I'm not gonna say that I have never lied before, because I have. Plenty of times, but for right reasons. For the good reasons, not the bad reasons. I can look back at my life and say, I hate myself for the things that happened that I couldn't control. Even though I have control of my own self, how can you have control of your own self if that which takes control was never of your own thoughts or actions or capabilities? Someone's putting that in your head. Don't let people gaslight you. Don't let people take control of your life, because if you let people take control of your life, you're not going to live happy. You're gonna live sad. You're gonna live depressed. You're gonna look at yourself in the mirror and say, I hate everything about you. And as I'm making this video, I am looking myself in my own eyes. Yeah, I'm telling myself, you need to stop being afraid. Because if you are afraid, if you let these people feed off your fear, they will take control of your life They will take control of your actions. And the entire process is just going to be coming out of their mouth. And you could have done that. You could have just let everything come out of your mouth. The truth. What really happened. But the moment you don't, you lose all integrity. Physically, mentally, emotionally, and socially. In the courtroom or around your friends. So when it comes to me, when I turn 24, I am hoping to be happier, to feel better about myself, to forgive and forget what I have done and what those have done unto me. And I'm not usually a fighter. I usually just mind my own business. I usually shy away. I usually hide. Hide how I feel, how I see things. Because in the end, it's not because I'm afraid that people are going to look at me and think of me different. But because I think that if I told people what was going on with me, that I would not have a chance to live a normal life. And my parents fed on that. The people driven my fears fed on that idea. To live a normal life, to be normal. Be happy. And I have to say, I regret ever trusting these people, for ever listening to these people. And I regret not saying anything, which that's a lie. I didn't say not anything. Because I did say something after every time and before every time. Every time I would get the treatment, I would tell them what happened. I would tell them what they were doing and what thoughts were going in my head. And they failed to realize that these thoughts were the products of the treatment because of a person who meant harm to me. And because of my treatment, statute of limitation does not apply to this scenario. So Claude William Goddard, Karen Christine Sherman, Larry Allen or Michael Grachowalski, the first. Or, junior. Charles the first, and Charles the second, and Charles the third. You can either come clean or not. Either way, I know more than you think. I've learned an art of applying individuals' behavior to myself. I've learned to mask how I feel. I've learned how to hide myself. And the reasons to why I'm making these videos is because I'm tired of hiding. I am tired of being held back. I am tired of being told what to do and what not to do. Good or bad, I am sick and tired of people taking control of my life and my actions, and making me do things that I don't want to do. And you can tell in this eye how painful it is. And you can tell in this eye how much truth I am telling you. How much neutral feeling that I just have right here. It's fear that's in this eye. And it's anger in this eye. Depression, sadness. It's all right here. Going through this brain, this hemisphere. And all my happiness. Right here. So, for those out there who lost hope, you don't know what you're doing. You're stuck rock bottom. You're afraid people hurt you too many times and you don't know what to do. You need to stand up. Don't let these people get away with what they're doing, because this is why our country is going to hell. By letting these people walk free, by letting them get out of prison for good behavior, even though they may have never changed, just done the time because they did the crime. That ain't learning your lesson, in my opinion. Learning your lesson would be feeling everything you put those people through. For me, anyone who's been molested, sex trafficked, given away, degraded, deprived of happiness and self-idealisms, or portrayals, if you're letting people at a young age control the way you think, you need to stop. You need, as a parent, tell your child that they are worth something, that they are worth fighting for, that they are worth every bit of struggle. Because if you don't tell them the positive things first, they're going to hate you. They're going to look at you like, why didn't you answer my questions? Why aren't you listening to me? Because when you're a child, when you're even an infant, at first you're not worried about learning how to communicate with these people, because you don't need to communicate. You already see it every single day as a child and as a baby. You see it. You see the look on their face. You see the anger. You see the fear. And you know it all too well. That's why it's bad for parents to have fights around their babies and their children. It's because what goes through their brain is nonstop fear. They know what's going on. Stop telling them that they don't. Because everything your child is feeling, everything you are feeling, is normal. You just got to accept it. And if you accept everything you feel, everything that happened to you, and everything that you've done, you will feel better about yourself. And I've had a lot of thinking about all this, my life, what I've been through. And I gotta say, I am proud of myself for doing what I thought I had to do in order to show people what they have to do. Because I wanted to represent the majority. I wanted to represent the 99% of the population that struggled. I've been through poverty. I've been through domestic violence. I've been bullied. I've been murdered. Attempted, at least, multiple of times. I've died. I've brought myself back, even after they gave up shocking me. Even after it seemed like it was hopeless, I didn't give up. And every day I tell myself I'm going to. And every day I fear for my life because I don't know what I'm doing. I just want you people to know that this is coming from my heart. I am not holding anything back. See, I'm crying now. And that's okay. It's okay to cry. Man or woman, baby or child, criminal or not, it is okay to cry. It's okay to have problems. It's okay to feel sad, to feel mad. And it's okay to question what's going on and question yourself. And it's okay to question other people. And it's okay to desire knowledge. But it's not okay to let people control your life and to control you in the way you feel, in the way you think, and the way you act, and how you do things, and why you do things. You shouldn't let people change you for who you are. If anything, the only person who should be changing you is you. And if you're letting people do this to you, you need to make a stand. You need to go to your friend's house and you need to ask to use their phone or their camera. Make a video and post all your problems in one simple video. And you need to tell people what these people have done to you. Don't be me and bite your tongue. And if you can't tell, I've done that plenty of times to the point where it hurts. far too much. So have hope. Don't give up. Do what's right. And if you know someone is going to do something that's wrong, forget them. Forget what they say. Forget what they're trying to tell you. Forget what you would tell yourself when these people would degrade you and make you feel hopeless. Don't tell yourself that you're going to give up. Don't tell yourself that these people are going to win. Because that's justice. Justice is fighting for what you believe in. And if you don't believe in yourself, where is the justice? And where are you going to end up at the end of the rope? This is Fixity Viability, over and out. I hope you have a great day. And please leave a comment. Please subscribe if you want more. If you have a problem and you want help about it, leave a comment down below. I am not a psychologist. I am not a therapist. I've studied psychology. I've studied sociology and microbehaviors. And I've been through it. I can honestly say I have been through almost everything that has to do with being sex trafficked, abused, drugged, or gaslighted. I've stolen before. I've hurt myself before. My entire arm up and down was covered with cuts. At one point, I wrote on my arm, "Never again." With a knife, not with a pen. And I hope this video tells people what they need to do. And better yet, don't even listen to what I say. Do what makes you feel comfortable. If you believe you should be doing something right now and you ought to be doing it, go do it. Right now. They try to tell you we can't do anything about it. You look at them and you tell them, are you refusing to investigate an act of crime being taken to you by a civilian in need? Because if they say, yes, I'm denying the investigation, yada yada, I don't want to do it, whatever. That's a police officer that won't do their job. That is poor customer service. And if they're not investigating for you, and if they're not investigating you in the process too, they are not doing their job. And if you let people step on you like that, you'll never get anything done. Because I've had officers blow off everything that I've been through. I've had the government tell me what was real and what was not, when what was real was real and what was not real was what they were telling me was not real. They would make me forget these things. And that's why I'm here. Because I'm tired of forgetting. I want to make a point. I want to make an example out of these people that hurt me. And no, posting a video about it probably isn't the best idea. But I know what I'm doing. I told them this is what I was going to do. And I told them this is what was going to happen. Because they didn't listen, shit got real. That's coming from a schizophrenic with borderline personality disorder, PTSD, anxiety, depression, suicidal tendencies, hallucinations, borderline or stress disorder. And what else? Yeah. That's basically everything that I can think of. Oh, and insane. In a sense, I'm perfectly normal to make a video, so I must not be that insane. So God bless you all for listening. I hope someone out there is able to help you. And I hope the people who I believe are helping me are planning on to. And if not, then I guess the only person I can help is myself. And that's exactly what you guys should be worried about when you're going through these situations of depression, drug use, and insanity. You gotta believe in yourself more. You got to start telling people what you want. Because if you don't, they're going to keep using you. They're gonna keep abusing you. And they're going to keep hurting you. You do not play a game to get shot. You play a game to get things done. So don't play. If you don't plan on pulling the trigger. Metaphorically speaking, doing what needs to be done. I'm not saying go shoot these people. I am not saying to go harm them. I am not telling you that it's worthless or it's not worth not killing them. That came out wrong. Sorry. I am telling you, you need to take action for yourself. And if you see someone out there who is not able to take action for themselves, stick up for the little guy. Please stick up for the little guy. Okay? My name's Austin, by the way. So, I'm 22. I am a chore provider. Essentially a maid. And I am insanely sane. Have a great day, everybody. I wish you luck. And keep that motivation. Maybe you too, like Beast that I showed you below, if you've watched it, you too can be like him, living a happy life. That's what I desire. Maybe that's what you should too.